You call yourselves officers of Kairos's army, but your conduct falls short of my expectations. The court finds your accounts of Vendrian's well lacking, rife with misdirection and fallacy, fouled with baseless accusation. Silence. The contradictions in your statements will be examined, and falsities threshed from truths. If we find you have perjured yourselves, Bled and Mark will see to your fate. Fatebinder, we will start with the matter of the Archons. Graven Ash and the voices of Nerat have declared war upon each other. In addition to violating Kairos's peace, they have thrown the conquest of the Tears into disarray. By all accounts, these hostilities began shortly after your arrival. Tell us what transpired. Your perspective is appreciated, but the dispositions of the two Archons are already a matter of record. Loyal subjects of Kairos have drawn blood from each other, a cardinal crime. Something happened at Vendrine's Well to trigger this feud. The Fatebinder presents testimony. I warn you both against speaking out of turn. Something more than a mere disagreement unraveled this campaign, but I will return to that in time. Let us speak of Ascension Hall. From all accounts, it would seem you were instrumental in its capture, or so the petitioner of the Scarlet Chorus testifies. The disfavored commander has a dimmer view of the matter. Lend me your perspective. The edict meant certain doom if the siege failed. So why, when your survival depended on it, did you join your strength to the Scarlet Chorus and not the elite disfavored? I will consider this testimony at length. The court thanks you for it. Is there anything you wish to add at this time? Your testimony is accepted by the court. The statements of our guests raise questions in my mind. There is much about this campaign that has caused me to wonder. A shipment of iron weapons was short on arrival. Where coveted iron is concerned, I don't believe it to be a clerical error. One of my agents recovered this seal in Echo Call. It belongs to a merchant collective. Lethian's Crossing is teeming with their kind. If you would root out treachery, I would advise starting there. Petitioners, leave us. I would have a private audience with the Fatebinder. Ascend and join me. You will find the way opened. This civil war, this feud, is an insult to Kairos' peace. It should not have taken the better part of a year to silence the last vestiges of the Oathbreakers. Our allies squabble while our enemies regroup. It falls upon the court to measure the extent of the damage and to execute the agents of disorder. I suspect that treachery, negligence, disunity, and greed have infected one or both of our esteemed allies. Until you are instructed otherwise, this matter is the court's primary focus. Graven Ash and the voices of Nerat must be examined in close detail. You are charged with observing the Archons and presenting your case that one of them has wrought chaos and disorder upon the Tears. It's possible, but the momentum of the conquest up to this point suggests otherwise. The failure at Vendrian's Well implies a coordinated will behind the chaos. As always, you will be held accountable for what you do in the court's name. But you are free to conduct your investigation in the manner of your choosing. You must expect lies, misdirection, and manipulation. Suffer not such obstructions of justice. They say the voices of Nerat holds you in higher regard than most. Use this alliance to enter his confidence. It seems unlikely the Archon of Secrets is more honest with friends than with rivals, but to his friends, he has been known to divulge much. The disfavored will likely be less cooperative with your investigation. They will no doubt assume Graven Ash's honor is beyond reproach, which is all the more reason to scrutinize the Archon of War closely. And if the Ironclad forces discourage your inquiry, I charge you to make them talk. Speak their language of battle if you must. Your fellow Fatebinders have been busy acting as my eyes and ears. I have a few leads for you to follow. You should, of course, speak with your brothers and sisters of the court if you need further counsel. Though the disfavored were triumphant in the Blade Grave, I understand that their troubles within the region are unfinished. Talk to the disfavored commanders serving in the Blade Grave. Perhaps they can shine some light on the origins of this feud. There is a final matter to discuss, a sensitive topic. In spite of the many shortcomings at Vendrian's Well, you managed to make a name for yourself. You proclaimed an Edict of Kairos, resolved its demanding conditions, and ascended the Mountain Spire. Any one of these feats would be worthy of recognition by the highest authority. You managed to accomplish three. It pleases me that you grasp your role, as long as you temper it with a sense of duty. Whether by design or by accident, you have captured the attention of Kairos' army and the local Tearsmen alike. This is no small opportunity, and the court charges you with exploiting your new standing to its fullest potential. You have a title in our hierarchy. However, it's a little-known secret that one's standing in the world is determined by their infamy, their deeds, and how they come to be known. Mind this notion as you bring justice to this lawless frontier. There may come a time when your deeds speak for you louder than any title. If your killing spree in the bastard city is any indication, you are no stranger to spreading infamy already. Whatever you did to capture the attention of the masses at Vendrian's Well, I would encourage you to do so again. Good. It falls to us to set a new standard for these southern barbarians. You are dismissed. Should the court have need of your presence, you will receive word. Go forth and do my bidding, and bring glory and honor to the Tears in Kairos' name.
Let's be off.